Now, ever since I got my hands on the Oppo Find X2 Pro, Oppo smartphones has always been my go-to recommendation if you're looking for a smartphone that always innovates. And this Oppo Find X5 Pro is no different. Where it has, in my opinion, during my first impressions, the best smartphone finish yet, a fantastic camera, a superb screen, making this a potential most complete smartphone. So what else is great about this phone? Well, let's find out. Now, the Oppo Find X5 Pro comes in a grey coloured box with number 5 on the top left and Oppo Find X5 Pro 5G towards the bottom middle of the box. Then on the right side of the box, there's the Oppo and the Hasselblad logo to signify the collaboration of the phone and Hasselblad, of course. And at the back, there are some of the specs and the colour variant that you choose. Opening the box, there is a smaller black box that contains the SIM ejector pin, the manuals, and the premium service card which has a QR code at the back where you can head to the premium service website. And speaking of premium, it also comes with a rather premium looking frosted TPU soft case as well. Nice. Then you'll find the phone itself. Underneath there's the USB A to USB-C cable and the 80W SuperVOOC charging brick. Next, looking at the design and the build quality of the phone, I have to start by talking about the back of the phone. Because just when I thought that Samsung's S22 Ultra and the iPhone 13 Pro Max had the sexiest white color finish, well, this Oppo Find X5 Pro has to be my new favorite. Firstly, it is made out of ceramic, which I've always preferred compared to a glass-backed smartphone because of its super tough build quality, and Oppo has done the weakest hardness scale to make sure that the phone is also scratch-resistant too. Now, because the phone is in white, there's absolutely no issues of having any smudges or fingerprints, which is of course a huge plus. And because of the unique camera bump at the back that slopes into the back panel at about 75 degrees, it made holding the phone way much better with my index finger nicely resting at the back just below the curvature of the camera bump. Now yes, a matte finish would make the phone even less slippery, but honestly, I didn't feel it was at all, where the phone was pretty light at 218 grams compared to a typical heavier flagship smartphones and is also really thin at 8.5mm. And the extra details are at the back, where you'll find the Powered by Mari Silicon, which represents the unique MPU that Oppo has built to ensure better image and also video processing. More on that later. Next, looking towards the right, there is the Oppo and the Hasselblad branding over there as well. Now, putting the phone and typing on the surface was great as it didn't wobble at all when I was using the keyboard, so that was really sweet too. Now, as for the phone's ports and buttons, other than the USB-C at the bottom, there is the dual SIM card slot with no micro SD card slot expansion. Then you'll find one of the two stereo speakers over there, where the other speaker is on the earpiece area, and it also supports Dolby Atmos as well. Then the volume rockers are on the left, with the power button being placed on the right. Then the front screen panel is curved at the sides, and it also has the Corning Gorilla Glass Victus protection with an in-display fingerprint sensor at a nice position that unlocks really fast. And it also had a nice rounded aluminium frames at the corners, hence making the phone really sleek, slim and premium, making the phone the most comfortable premium flagship smartphone that I've held thus far. And to top all of that up, it has an IP68 dust and water resistant rating, and other than this ceramic white color, it is also available in glaze black. Now, as for the phone's display, the Oppo Find X5 Pro has a 6.7-inch AMOLED LTPO display, and my first impressions when I turned on the phone was how bright that the screen was, where it had a peak brightness up to 1300 nits. And I love how Oppo has kept it consistent on giving the best displays on this Find X series with an A+ for the Display Mate certification, as it is a 13-bit high-quality display panel which showcases more than 1 billion colours, where no matter if there's a tiniest shift of colour when you're watching any videos on the screen, because of the full depth and the range of the screen, it will show it as colour accurate as a high-quality PC monitor because of how well it identifies sRGB and DCIE P3 colour gamut. Then the screen has the dynamic refresh rate up to 120Hz, and because this is an LTPO panel, it can go down all the way to 1Hz when you're on a static screen, and it will raise the refresh rate higher based on the screen activity, hence saving battery. So yes, I'm eager to see how well the battery performance is when I put my SIM card and use it daily. But as of now, when it comes to navigating, scrolling, was super responsive due to its massive 1000Hz touch sampling rate. And of course, when it comes to reading static text on websites with the phone, was very crisp and sharp indeed. And coupled with the higher resolution of WQHD Plus of 1440 by 3216 pixels and a 92.7% screen-to-body ratio, it made watching videos on the phone highly satisfying, especially when watching videos on Netflix where it had Widevine L1, full HD playback with HDR10 HEVC capable as well. Now, when it comes to the phone's cameras, the Oppo Find X5 Pro comes with a 50-megapixel f1.7 IMX766 sensor for the main camera and another 50-megapixel f2.2 ultra-wide lens with the same IMX766 sensor and a 30-megapixel f2.4 telephoto lens. So yes, the cool microscope camera which the Find X3 Pro had isn't here, and that was fine by me because while it was cool to have that, I felt like it was more like a nice-to-have lens, and I'd rather have this telephoto dedicated lens instead of that microscope lens. Then the front camera has a 32-megapixel f2.4 IMX709 sensor, where it will adjust the focal length to a wider focal length if you have more than one person taking a selfie. Now, I did take several quick test shots and I'm really seeing how well the Hasselblad color collaboration is. Now, compared to how the images was when they first collaborated with OnePlus, it was nice that all of the images were tweaked very well in these images, especially for the rear camera photos. And I also believe that this is because of the dedicated Mari Silicon X Imaging NPU as well, because this chipset is built on a 6nm process that helps with the overall image processing, which looks more like film level quality, and it works both for images and videos as well. Now, speaking of video, the rear camera records up to 4K 30 frames per second with 5-axis optical stabilization, where as seen in these quick test shots, it totally looks like a gimbal stabilization. And the front camera records up to 1080p up to 30 frames per second, where if you want to toggle the image stabilization, there is an option for you to do so. Otherwise, in default, it won't have any stabilization. And of course, I'll be testing out the cameras both on the picture modes and also the video modes, especially during low light, since it is one of the biggest strengths that Oppo has highlighted on the phone. So stay tuned for my full video review and subscribe to this channel in case you haven't done so. Next, the Oppo Find X5 Pro ships with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. Yes, the chipset which has been very well known to be extremely hot. So let's hope that that's not the case on this phone, since it has the multi-tier cooling system, which apparently has a 75% bigger vapor chamber compared to the previous generation. Then in terms of the RAM and the storage configuration, the variant that I have is the 12GB of RAM and 256GB of storage, which is the only variant available here in Malaysia. And of course, there is the RAM expansion option that uses the storage to convert into a virtual RAM, where you can choose between 3, 5 and 7GB of virtual RAM, giving you a potential memory increase up to a freaking 19GB of RAM. Then as for the phone software, it comes shipped with ColorOS version 12, which is one of the most stable Android skins that I had no complaints with, especially with the number of privacy features as well. And there's plenty of other software features that I do appreciate, like the quick launch shortcuts menu from the in-display fingerprint sensor, multi-screen connect to connect the phone to a PC, and of course all the other personalized options that has for the screens, the icons, and even the haptics as well. Then in terms of the battery, it has 5000 mAh of battery, which is a higher capacity than the previous Find X3 Pro, where it only had 4500 mAh. And it also is a dual cell battery as well. Then the fast charging has also improved significantly to 80 watts SuperVOOC instead of 65 watts last year. And even the wireless charging is now at 50 watts AirVOOC as opposed to only 30 watts for the previous model. So now it can actually go from nearly empty to 100% in just 47 minutes to this fast wireless charging method. So yes, I'm looking to see how much of a battery life that I could get on the phone daily, especially on the charging speeds, as Oppo has advertised the phone to go from 0 to 50% in just 12 minutes. So with this, do let me know what you would like to specifically know about this Oppo Find X5 Pro in the comment section below, and I'll revert back in my full video review.